Hello and welcome back to Thalric Plays Blood Bowl 2. Originally, I was planning on playing the Lizardman today, but I am feeling more in a little bit of an orky mood and a low team value mood, to be honest. So that's what we're going to do. We will play the Lizardman next time, and today we're going to go with the Orcs. The last match we did lose, unfortunately, against that Skaven team that had a higher team value than we did. And if I remember correctly, we were also pretty beat up. I don't know. Maybe I misremember it. Or did I? I don't know. Either way, we lost, so that's... Yeah, he had his one-turn touchdown player. I think that what made things very difficult for us. So, let's just try to find an opponent. We are at full strength right now. We've got 12 players, all rerolls. I didn't buy an assistant coach and a cheerleader yet. We'll wait on that a little bit longer, probably. It's only a minor buff to the team value, but at the moment I don't know. I feel like we're at an okay point and they don't matter too much. But we'll have to wait and see. So as always, I will cancel that after a moment and requeue. I don't know if that actually does anything, but it appears to be working at least some of the time. So we'll do that. And let's see what we actually end up with. So, we are at the moment 3 games into the Orc team, and this will be the 4th. And I would like to hear your opinion on the team so far. What do you think of the Orcs? Do you like the matches with them? Do you think I'm doing a good enough job of playing them? So if you have any feedback or criticisms, just let me know. I would really appreciate that. And I'm going to cancel one more time in a moment here, and if we don't find anything, then I will just leave it running. Or I will just pause the video until we find something. I don't know. Let's take another quick look here. Nothing to see, actually. So let's just try again, and hopefully we will find something soon. Apparently not. Okay, so I think we should just... Let's talk about some stuff here. If you watched the first 2 community matches, you know that I and a few others are currently thinking about starting a Blood Bowl 2 league, a small league. So far we have 4 interested participants at the point of this recording, which in theory is enough to start, and we will most likely do that with 4 if no one else steps forward and we get up to 6, because that would be the next higher number. There are no decisions. Oh god. Yeah, that's what I was afraid of. So that's going to be fun. Let's see, we have a lot of petty cash, and we will need that probably. So he's got a troll slayer. What's that? Stand firm. Okay, with guard and stand firm. Oh, hello, that's a big runner. He's fast, he's got Hail Mary pass, kickoff return, and block. That seems reasonable. A blitzer. With guard, stand firm, mighty blow, grab. Perfect. That's guard, mighty blow, stand firm, armor value 8. Nothing. Guard, stand firm. Guard, stand firm, armor value 8, guard, mighty blow, and guard. Okay, so a standard dwarf team. 3 rerolls. Okay, yeah, that's going to be interesting. Let's see, what do I have available in terms of star players? So we could get Morgenthorg. but I'm really not sure. Maybe Varagulchur would be a good idea. So let's start with the obvious. We will buy a wizard. I would like a bribe. I would like one Bloodwiser babe. I want the bribe, probably. I don't know how useful it will be against dwarves, though. Yeah, okay, I need to hurry here. So, bribe and an extra reroll might be good, considering we don't have a lot of block yet. Well, some, but it could be better. So this is the semi-safe choice here. I did not go for a star player because that would mean I wouldn't be able to get a wizard. We've got some offensive inducements in the form of the bribe. And I did not go for a second apothecary because we have armor value 9 and we should hopefully not need it. Against dwarves, you never know. We do have the strength advantage, but he has a lot of guard and two players with Dauntless, so this will probably be very hard. And since we had that nice guy last time, I don't know, I shouldn't just stop doing this because we had one bad experience. So, dwarves, the usual. They are fairly slow. He does have one runner, though, with movement allowance 7, which is pretty fast. The fourth reroll should allow us to maybe reroll a block result or two, so be a little bit more aggressive. And it looks like he's setting up very aggressively on the line of scrimmage. And with all the guard he has, we need to be very careful with how we block, because he will basically get an assist every time. So that's going to be difficult. Or make things difficult, I should probably say. But maybe we can get a chain going here if we start with a Black Orc. We have a Black Orc with block. Yep, we've got Warrior here. If we start blocking from here, then we get one assist, and maybe we can create an assist chain down the way, but it looks like he's not setting up as aggressively as I first assumed. So we'll have to wait and see. And I actually should probably do this. Oh boy, I don't like this. Let's just assume that everyone has guard. The problem here also is stand firm. So he's got these guys. Yeah, that's going to be interesting. Let's see. I'm a bit torn on how to set up here, honestly, because of all the guard. And I don't have too much time to think about it. On top of it. Which makes things a little bit more difficult, but I should probably try to force some blocks here. The stand firm makes things a bit annoying, honestly. Yeah, okay, let's do that and see how this turns out. Okay, I don't know, this will either go pretty okay. Of course he gets a blitz, so that basically destroys my whole offense already. Because he can move in every guard player, and we Even if I get assists, we won't get easy blocks, and he can blitz me on top of everything. So this is a horrible start. Nothing is really decided yet, but it will make things very difficult. That's the strength of the dwarves, basically. They have... Basically every player has guard, mighty blow, stand firm at a later point, and that makes it really hard to play against them. They do fall off against teams like Chaos and other teams with that can bash them back. But not only are we could bash back, but our team value is 420 lower than his. So the skill gap is really big. And yeah, he is just moving everyone in here somewhere, and I won't get any two dice blocks here. This is not a two dice block because this guy has guard. This is a two dice against block because this guy has guard. And that's just the fun things. So the only way I can get one here is moving him in. And that's just perfect. So I will have to do one dice blocks here, and very soon probably. Okay, yeah, this is not good. There's not really much we can do, and I already see my blocks failing here. Yep, there it is. He does not have stand firm on this guy. So let's do this and stay. Still makes this a one dice. No, it's... Oh, yeah. Okay, I do get the assist here. Okay, that's an okay start. Oh, okay, we stunned him. That should at least make things a little bit easier. So I get one dice blocks at a few points. These, for example. So I still need to do the pickup next, just because I will do one dice blocks here. And if I fail, this is open. Basically, the only good thing is that the dwarves are just so slow. This guy does not have stand firm, so we can do this block, and if we get a knockdown, which we don't, we would have gotten an assist. He shouldn't be able to reach me with his blitzers or throw slayers, so he can't surf me. And let's stay as well. Oddly enough, I want to stay out of contact with this guy, which sounds really weird, but makes perfect sense in my opinion. And I will do more one dice blocks, probably. Yeah, let's go over here. Yep, that's no good, so we will take the first reroll, and there's the attacker down. So that's a big problem right now. The blitz basically destroyed my whole offense. Otherwise, I could have gotten some assists and blocked his line of scrimmage and made a blitz. But because he has so much guard, he can just negate all of my advantage I could have gotten here. So what we have to hope for now is that he doesn't get too many knockdowns, and even if he does, see something like this happens, where if he doesn't follow up, we get a good block back, but he will probably follow up basically everything. But so far, at least, my hopes for the block results are fulfilled. And that's also why I didn't follow up a lot of the blocks. We want to stay out of contact to decide where we want to give assists, so that we can get the situations we need. So this is probably a blitz with this guy, maybe? Maybe he wants to set up a surf? We'll see. And that last one dice I probably shouldn't have done because I don't have block on that guy. But I still wanted to try, and it backfired, so now I have to kind of live with it. That's what I was afraid of, if not following up. He's setting up a serf, so I won't... I should not stand him up. Probably, yeah, he will most likely move here. Or he... I don't know, maybe he should have followed just to get the serf. Or the possible serf. That way, at least I can try to dodge away as a last action. So it's pretty obvious what I will most likely try, I think. Which is, yeah, he makes this more, a lot more difficult though. We'll have to wait and see. I was thinking about crossing over this way because we have the black orcs here that are not in contact. And had an okay chance here. But now I'm not sure yet. We'll have to assess the situation. The big thing is I do have warrior here, who we can use to blitz one of these two. I would like to go on the troll slayer, but we can't without doing a going for it. We could do this, which would give me an assist, and then I could block there. That might work. Yeah, let's... But this would be a two dice if I moved him there. Yeah, this is really tough right now. Okay, so let's... It's a bit risky because I'm putting myself really close to this, but I need to move. And that way we at least make some forward progress. And then let's do this, because if it works, it will get us an okay chance here, I think. So blitz next, just to be on the safe side. Thank you for that. And I would like to follow, yes. Then we can do this one. Okay, not what I was hoping for. Obviously. This one's next. And I actually will stay, because we need to try and form a cage sooner rather than later. And now I can basically try what I was trying for the first turn, which is set up a blockchain here. He's got stand firm, he won't move. So that I can get the blocks that I want. And it is working really well right now. So that will make things a lot easier. Thank you. And put you over there and follow as well. And then I'll dodge with Orchid. And that is the greedy move that I'm doing right now, which is this going for it so that I get this last block here. Okay, it didn't work out, but at least we have two players on this guy. And he shouldn't be able to reach me. We knocked down most of his team. So he will get two blocks plus a blitz maximum. He can't get more. Which is a big improvement. So he's moving them all back in, which is what we were expecting. And I don't really know where we want to go yet. This is dangerous territory because of these two guys. But this is a pretty... It's hard to penetrate this. Okay, we got stunned. So even if I manage to get a breakthrough somewhere, he's still got his runner back here, so he needs to push us there, which is what he's doing. Okay, nice. At least his troll stairs are underperforming at the moment. Well, this one is. The other one got an armor break. These setups here are... Our situation was okay, but now it's getting worse again just because he has all those guard guys and we are all bound up. So I don't really get to give assists as much as I would like to. And that's a problem. We do have one 2-dice block available at the moment. Which is not a lot, as you all know. And that is against this guy. So either from over here, nope, not even that, just from here. So we need to do that first. Yeah, this is bad. We need to get the knockdowns, and I can't even follow. I need to free up that line orc. Okay, so this is a 2-dice as well with block. So he will stay where he is, unfortunately. Okay, so these are 2-dice against blocks because he's a jerk, basically. let's do this one as well. And if we fail and he's smart, he will not use stand firm. Well, I would have just chain pushed differently, but I don't know. So, what are our options right now? This is the only player we can move freely at the moment. So this is a 2-dice, and if we get it, I can get an okay block over here. I think we should try that. The alternative would be to blitz here or there. You know what? Actually, let's try this. I like this better. It gets us one more block. Nope, it does not, because he's got stand firm. Well, we still got this one. Doesn't matter, because I don't get the rolls I need. Hooray. Okay, this guy does have stuff. I really don't like this. It's just horrible to play against a dwarf team that has a higher team value than you do. And he will get a lot more blocks this turn. That's a really big deal. And I'm almost out of time. Oh, crap. Yeah, it's a bit of a stupid move, but I will do this. I hope it works out. This is a 1-dice now. It's only a push, which is not what I was hoping for. Let's follow this, and I will also try to dodge here just because we need to. And let's pull him over there. I could have gone aggressive and tried a pass, but that's not really how orcs should work, or probably will work, and we are over here, so a pass over there is not that good of an idea. But he will have a harder time marking this guy, so at least we have a blitzer that we can blitz with next turn or get an assist somewhere. Yeah, that's good enough. It's with... No, he blocked with this guy. And there's another stun. Oh boy. Yeah, if he had blocked with this guy, he would have been free to get the assist, and then he could have gone here somehow. Whatever. Okay. This guy has a 1-dice right now. Yep, but he can change that. And I might already be forced to use the wizard. At the moment, we're not there yet, but we need to start making some progress here. And dwarves are just very good at stopping stuff like that, because he's a wall right now. I can't make any forward progress. And he gets two players onto the ball. So that was a big mistake. And he gets three players on the ball if he wants to go there with his runner. Yeah, this is just horrible. Yep, he's making sure we can't really move. Oh, wow. Yeah, makes sense. Makes a lot of sense. And it's good enough, I don't have block yet. And we get stunned, so that's perfect. Holy crap. At least he fails that, so he needs to use a going for it, but he will do that. So he has a ball, a guy next to the ball. So that's big fun. Yeah, this is bad. This is really bad. And I probably... Okay. Hello. More stuns. Armor value 9. Heard of it? Come on, game. Please. So this guy does not have guard. So we can actually get... Nope. This guy does have guard. I hate playing against dwarves. It's just so annoying. Oh boy. Yeah, these are all... No, I actually have a 2 dice here. And this needs to work. Yeah, let's stand up warrior. We won't blitz with him. Please work. I need this to work. I need this to work. Nope. Not happening. The game is hating me again. And I'm sorry that I'm getting annoyed and that you're hearing that I'm getting annoyed, but this is just... amazing fun here. First he gets the blitz, then I fail the important blocks again. It's just not fun anymore. That's just so bad. And I can't even do anything because... I shouldn't complain. I should think. So we have 2 options. Go for the 1 die splits, hope for the best, try to pick up the ball and run away. We could try to do a dodge first so that we could do a 2 dice. So let's go for option 3, which is marking this first, then dodging and blitzing with him. Which is this option I'm going for. And I use the reroll first, so... at least we get it. Okay, thank you. And then I will opt for the even riskier choice, which is this dodge, followed by a pickup attempt, which we fail. And the ball, of course, scatters into his direction. So that's just amazing. At least I've got 3 players on the ball. And in the end, it might just still come... Yeah, he gets his blocks, which is a big problem. We can't afford to be on the ground all the time. We need players standing up to block his path. So I'm trying to get rid of the saltiness and get thinking again. Because this should still be doable. It's really hard and really unlikely to work. But maybe. It's a big maybe. The problem is that he's got guard, he's got dauntless, he cannot bash us. And that's always a problem when you're playing a bash team yourself, when you can't beat the opponent at your strength. It's a problem. And he will also move up his players again so that I won't be able to really move around a lot. So I will have to do 1 dice blocks again, or maybe even a 2 dice against block. It's just not happening here. Yep, he gets that as well, of course. And if my own players weren't in right in the mix, I would try to use a fireball. It's at least would get some knockdowns, especially considering the density of his players here. But from the way things are, yeah, he doesn't need that. It's just really bad. Yep, there he is. So he can knock us around a little bit more. But that's basically it. He won't pick up the ball. So let's stand everyone up. And these are all just amazing blocks. Let's do this. And why would it work? Honestly, what am I expecting here? But I won't use a push because that would put me next to a guard player, which would allow him to blitz us. So I will now start doing stupid stuff, just so you know. So my first stupid action here is doing this two dice against blitz. I can't afford to reroll that. He will take this result, which will mean we will both one move. But yeah, one dice. Thank you. Wow, the first one in quite a while. Let's follow. And that's basically it. Yep, I can't do anything more. I hope for something like a push and a good result so that we can push him on the ball and see if we maybe get a good scatter. It's a dumb move, of course, but we're in a situation where we probably need to start doing stuff like this, unfortunately. It's just the blitz result screwed us over really hard. I was purposefully going for offense first because I wanted to knock him down a little bit, if we can, but it just backfired horrendously. And now the scatter goes right inside his players. So, and he stunned us again. I mean, this is the only player we have with armor value 8. But this is still pretty bad. And there's the next one. So this gets worse and worse. Yep, there's the next knockdown. Okay, so I regret being in the mood for playing orcs right now. Pretty heavily. And there's no more tackle zones on the ball. There's also only one player of mine remaining in this cluster. So maybe it's time for a fireball? And just hope that I don't injure my own player? Does that create a turnover? If I hit myself, I don't know. Oh, he's doing stuff like that, so that's a lightning bolt. We can't afford to do anything else. It's probably won't even... Oh, come on, really? It probably still won't even save us, but we still have to try. Because otherwise he can just stall this out and then he can go for... in his half, go for the touchdown. Yep, another knockdown. So our position is horrible and will not get any better. And this move is just the icing on top of everything because I wanted to dodge like this. And now there's a guy in the way. Nope, can't do that yet. Need to start with the wizard. And I completely forgot that I have a bribe, and couldn't have even used it. So what we can hope for is that. Not the killing, but the injury. Because that puts this guy off the pitch, and hopefully he's still injured, so it's at least a miss next game. Oh, wow, so that guy is probably not doing anything in the near future. Let's do this one next. And I need to at least try to move a player back there. Even though it's really unlikely for him to get there. At least he's taking it like he should. It's Blood Bowl, so stuff like this happens. And then all my saltiness. This is still an okay game, in all honesty. Let's not follow this. Oh, thank you. We need this right now. This could make a big difference. Because he does not have reserve players. So even if we fail now in this half, we might still win in the end. Or at least get a tie game. This is just really important right now. Let's push him there and stay. Is that the right move? I am not sure, but it's the one I'm making. So these are all pretty terrible. This is a one dice. But I don't really want to do a one dice. I want to do a dodge. Let's see first if it works. Okay, at least we're dodging, okay. We haven't failed a dodge yet. But he can just follow me and blitz me, so I need to do going for it here. Which I'm not particularly a fan of. There it is. We need to reroll that, though. We can't really afford... Okay, of course. Yep, there's the double one. That's pretty bad. So, the good thing here is all of his players, except his blitzers, have agility 2. So for them, picking up the ball is not that easy. Well, it's still a 4 plus roll, so 50-50, but it could be a lot better, i.e. a 3 plus roll. For example, with this guy. He's a blitzer, he's got agility 3. Apparently he does only have one blitzer, though. So ball handling will actually be a pretty problematic path for him. Did I injure his other blitzer? No, that was a long beard. Yeah, he only has one blitzer. That's weird. Okay, yeah, it's... We have 2 turns left. In all likelihood, we won't score. That's just not happening. In all likelihood, he still might, which is a bit of a problem, because he moved his blitzer over here. But maybe I can try. Yeah, these two are the only ones we can get a touchdown with. It's as weird as that sounds. Because they need to go 12 spaces, and they have exactly 4 plus 4 going for it in movement. Oh, let's see. He doesn't want to push me closer in case he fails, or if he fails his first block. Yep. So anyway this turns out, it will be a one-dice block, and I really hope he gets an attacker down. Oh, it's a two-dice against. It's a two dice against. He needs to reroll that. He doesn't. Oh, this is... I mean, it's still really unlikely, but I will try. Some risky and stupid stuff now. Let's see. If I do this and that... Let's do this block first. Okay, that does nothing for us. Anything? I would like to block here. Because we have two dice blocks, but it's still with players that don't have block. And that's the problem. I don't like this one bit. So anyway, this turns out we need to move him over this way, just so that we have the potential for, even if it's only next turn, that it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So we need to make one going for it, and there's the one. We might as well. My team still can... Oh, wow. 4 ones with going for it. So his blitzer now has a... has a free shot at the touchdown. Can pick up the ball on a 3+ with a reroll and then go for it. In the sense that he can go for the touchdown, but he will probably also have to use going for it. It's 1, 2, 3. My god, I hate that auto-adjusting camera. It's so annoying. I just want to plan my move here and see what he can do and not be auto-adjusted. I really hope they change that at some point. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yeah, he can with 2 going for it get it this turn, but he has 1 turn time to do that. So we probably won't. So we have to put our hopes in the second half and just hope that he now doesn't get it. We can't get a touchdown anymore. Yep, that's the smart move. It will force us to dodge in case he botches this and he wants to take probably another turn. But he gets the pickup. So this is just... Oh, wow. Oh, thank you. He falls down. But as long as he as well doesn't roll a double... Oh, he does. Really? Wow. I did not expect that. We're still far from safe, unfortunately, but things are getting better. This is... I mean, at least he needs to try and pick up the ball again. So at least we have that going for us. So let's start this with some blocks, probably. I still want to do this dodge, but we have a lot of blocks with players that have block available. So I'm counting on the fact that I won't roll double skulls. And we just need to make sure that we can... If we dodge, he can't get an assist somehow over there. Let's follow. Maybe we can get a knockdown. A good one. Armor value 8 is at least a little bit more likely. Nope. So I haven't blitzed yet. Well, we probably should blitz and then move right there. It's, I think, our best move right now. Okay, good. Put you there. Don't follow. Oh, nice. Another injury. Wow. This is turning around right now. This is really good. So please don't fall. Oh, thank you. Okay, this is good. This is really good. Oh yeah, he's got stand firm on that guy as well. And that will end it. We won't score. He still might. All he needs is a push, the pickup, and the score. Could work. Yep, there's the knockdown. And he still has that reroll left. It's one going for it again. But we'll see. There's the success, and there's the touchdown. Okay, so he's in the lead after all. But at least we're going into the second half with a big player advantage. When I completely forgot, our opponent's name is Mr. Tomix, and I will tell you his team's name in just a moment. Let's put some orcs there. Yeah, we need to put one black orc there. Though, I don't want to go full black orc because it's not a good idea. He's got Dauntless, he's got Guard. I don't want to deal with that, obviously. We do have him that doesn't have a skill yet, so we can do these. And because he's got Frenzy, I won't close the sides. It probably won't matter anyways. But we should set up a Frenzy trap in all likelihood. Which just means that I will put this guy right there. And we can move these up one as well. Frenzy trap meaning that if he wants to push with block here with one of his Dauntless players and he fails, he will push and run into an assist from us. So that should make a difference. We'll see. The big thing right now is that he has only 8 players left and only one player with agility 3 that can try to pick up the ball. Oh, I really hope we can turn this around. And we still have that bribe left, and I won't hesitate to use it if we get a good chance to do it. Preferably with the linemen, of course. They're the most expandable. But if it comes down to it, I will foul with a blitzer. It's still, if we get caught, it's a 1 in 6 chance that the bribe will fail, so it should be okay in all likelihood. We have seen the bribe fail already, not ourselves, but on another team or on the opponent's team. Okay, so we are at 5 rewards now, and that's a touchback. Unfortunately, otherwise this would have been perfect. So that okay, he still goes for a blitzer. I wanted to say that he could give it to an agility 2 player because he doesn't need to roll for the pickup. The backside here is that he won't follow us because he doesn't want to deal with this. Interesting. There's the knockdown. Yep, good enough. So who did get the injuries? Yet, it was Awakening. And what you're looking at, I think, and one more. I know we got one out of the you all know what I want to say. Oh, nice. We got one out of the lightning bolt. And the good thing here is he can't cage very well. Well, he can move here and try to cage, but if we can maybe create an opening somewhere, which we should be able to, I think. He's trying to create a screen with body blocking, but now he can't work with his guard advantage anymore that much. He will probably move somewhere around here. Oh, he actually goes there. That's still fine. We can reach him. Oh, hello. So this is going really bad for him right now. Oh, wow. Yeah, that's exactly why you should do these one by one if you can. Because if you fail the first one, you might not want to do the second one. And this will allow us to pick up the ball, in all likelihood. Let's stand up our players first, though. That's always something we need to do. I'm moving him here, just so that afterwards, after this block, we still have room to move here. Otherwise, we would block ourselves and we wouldn't be able to move past this. He's got stand firm, though, so he probably won't move. That's fine at the moment. We can still blitz, and we will do that. It still wanted... We have 5 rerolls. What am I... Okay, of course. It's just... Every time. I think it's the second time this has happened, where I try to get to the ball and reroll the blitz to actually create an opening to get there. And we roll double skulls in the reroll. I mean, yeah, this is 2 dice blocks again. This is a 2 dice as well if he gets the Dauntless. But now he can secure the ball again. This is a 2 dice if he gets the Dauntless. That's just, yeah, the double skulls cost us our good opportunity here. So things will get more complicated again. But our black orcs are really strong right now, just because we have the player advantage, so their strength 4 is a much bigger asset. This is still a 2 dice block. And we can still reach this. Oh, he's going in for the assist. It does make sense in some regard. It's not a lot of guard. Oh, it's still a 2 dice. Yep. But now he needs the Dauntless, and he... Wow. He's rolling really bad right now. He gets it, though, with the 1 dice. It's a bit unfortunate. But he's actually in a pretty okay situation. That's a reroll. I don't know, will he take it? He does. Oh, double skull. That's actually really good, of course. So, how do we do this best now? I think we should start with this blitz, or nope, we should start with this move, just so that we have another player in the way. And I should also, well, after the blitz, because it might change our positioning. It's fine. We won't get an attack on his ball carrier, but at least we will put some pressure on him. And this is now a 2 dice. Okay, he's not moving. So actually, let's do this one next, just so that we can move this black orc over. Or maybe we want to move him in here to get an assist. That's probably better. Let's go here. We're still using our movement and moving closer, but we're getting blocks out of it, which is preferable right now. Yeah, let's do the important block next, which is this one. It is more important. We won't reroll that. If we don't have to, let's push you there and stay, just so that what you're looking at is not going to be in contact next turn, most likely. And this is looking okay at the moment. The knockdown here would have been huge. It's pretty unfortunate that we didn't get it. But not really much we can do about that. At least this will stay one dice blocks. Because even if he stands up this guy, we still have an assist from here. And the Blitzer is also pretty slow. Oh wow, he's getting really bad rolls right now. The stun is okay, considering what's happening at the moment, I think. So that's the ballsy move. Oh, he's even doing more going for it. Oh, hello. Wow. Yeah, he needs to take risks now, and he's doing so. Yep, he will force me to do dodges, so he's making the best of a crappy situation, and it might work out for him. Which makes me really nervous, to be honest. Really nervous. Oh, crap. Yeah, he needs to stand up anyways. So how do we do this best? This is a one dice because he's got... We need to get this knockdown, and I really hope that we will. And I'm not standing up my other players because... It depends. Yep, I need to re-roll this. No, I don't. We have one more option here. It means we won't be moving our thrower, so we can as might as well stand him up. Thank you. The problems I need to do going for it now. What I don't really want to do. But we don't have that big of a choice. I need to get an assist here. Okay, nice. So he's got stand firm, so we actually would like to... Well, it doesn't matter too much, but... Let's do this. Okay, there's the knockdown. Oh, he's actually choosing to be pushed back. That's surprising. And we KO'd him. Wow. So this... we got really lucky with our armor breaks here. There's no question about that. And let's do this one. I won't pick up the ball this turn, but I at least want a player on there, just in case. Let's do this one. So what are our options? Probably... It's one less block. If we do it like this, but I get to move the Black Orc, which is what I want. Okay, yeah, let's move him right there. And this is still pretty bad, so we won't do those. So apparently me being salty paid off. Or we're just being rewarded for a really crappy first half. I don't know. It's always when I'm complaining and then the game turns around like this, I start feeling bad. because then it sounds like I complained about nothing, basically. I mean, we're still behind, but I hope we can be able to tie the game, maybe even win. But that's still far off, so let's not talk about that yet. But yeah, we still need to pick up the ball and do all those funny things, which might not work, and we're not that fast when moving down the pitch on top of it. Okay, works. But that's actually okay for us at the moment, because it frees up our thrower, who we want to pick up the ball with, just because he has sure hands. But he's still doing a very good job. He's keeping his calm, and he moved this guy back to potentially intercept us if we move down there. And he's trying to put pressure on us on this side. So he's playing very well, I think. So I would like to blitz this guy first. It's good enough. We're pushing him away. Next is this move. Then let's try to pick up the ball. Okay, that got me nervous there for a moment. Okay, so how do we do these best? Probably go right there. Yep, we're still pushing. Let's try this again. Once again, pushing. Because Blood Bowl doesn't want me to get a knockdown there, apparently. At least this one works. Let's do this one as well. Okay, nice. And this one. I mean, this Black Orc is going nowhere because he's just standing up every time and we can't do anything about it. Fouling here won't really help. We would get only one assist because the other ones are next to guys of his. So let's not do that. Let's go next to this guy. He will probably move him over and get a block, but it's better than him moving over this way. And I think my thoughts of getting a win are a bit too ambitious. We would need to do some pretty big stuff like passing or handing off the ball to Awakening and then doing going for it to get a touchdown in two turns from now on, so that we have two more turns with him receiving to do another touchdown. So we should probably just try to play it safe and go for a draw. It's fine, really, I think. If we can get through, Wasted will get a level up if he gets the touchdown and we don't get knocked down with him again. And Awakening already has his level up. So those are the big points here. And there goes his last reroll, maybe? He might not want to take that, yep. That's what I assumed. So, this one needs to go first. Oh, come on. I just can't get the blocks I need here. For some reason. Let's try again. I can't block this Troll Slayer. For reasons unknown. Yeah, push him there. And stay, actually. We don't need to follow this. So this is the one I want to do. Okay, now we can start attacking this guy. Orcan can go for a blitz here. Without going for it? Yep. And let's follow. And we need to secure still, so let's move Wasabi over here. He might try to dodge. It's not unheard of. I'm still not getting the opportunity to foul, and I might not, but we'll see. And I don't have to use up any rerolls right now, which is really nice. Yeah, I won't push you there. Let's push you here. And I still need to follow. Just so that he can move this guy. So he starts to not use this anymore. Okay, there's the stun, so we can finally move this black orc. And that ends our turn. Okay, I'm really amazed that it's going as it's going right now. After the first half, or at least two-thirds of the first half, because at the end of the first half we already had two injuries on him, or all three, I think. It just looked like it would end horrible. Oh, there's the one dice. Not good enough. Yeah, it's good enough. It's only in... And there's a KO on Orc City. Okay. That's not a big... Shouldn't be a big deal. A dick deal. That's not what I wanted to say. Okay, so we always need to be moving with him. Because if we just fail one thing, things will get very close. And we don't want that. So let's put you there. Let's do the safe block again, and we still don't get it. Oh, wow. Okay, then this one next. Also not moving. Uh-huh. Yep, there goes the reroll. Finally. Thank you. Oh, damn. Oh, damn. I'm... So that's the the nice guy in me, maybe. I still have the bribe, and I should foul. But I feel like that would be too much. So I won't. And I hope you can all understand and forgive me if you're a little bit more bloodthirsty than not going to foul him. At least the way things are looking right now, I really think we don't want to do that. I know how salty I get when things don't go my way, and I know what he's going through, so yep. Oh wow. So at least I will spare him in that regard. Yeah. I did not expect this turnout. But getting that on a black orc. let's look at the knight set. What you're looking at, it's really nice. So this is, if that works, that could become a problem because we still need to get there. Okay, but he's doing other stuff first, as he should. So he's at 4 out of 6, so only one more. He should have gone here, or he should go here. It won't matter. 1, 2, 3, 4, yep. He can't get here to get a blitz. Well, he could, but it would require more blocks. Or dodges, I mean. Okay, so he will probably use his last reroll for that, because he kind of needs to. Okay. And let's see what happens. Okay. So that secures the draw. Oh, wow. Yeah, let's just move there. And if we're already here, let's do another block with what you're looking at. Maybe we can get another injury in, but we should do this block at least first. Okay, did not work. So we'll just get another chance here. Just because we have block on those guys. I do have block on him as well, but if we... And on the off chance that we get another injury, he would level up. And so I will be greedy now, because we can afford to be. I feel like. But it looks like we won't really need to, so let's see. Does he use Stand Firm? Apparently not. Okay. Let's follow. So these are all terrible. This guy can't reach me no matter what I do. So we can pull back the black, the blitzers. And blitz with one of them. Maybe Orcan will get lucky here. He does not. Let's move there. And I'm doing this one first. It's both without block, but here we have ammo value 8 as an opponent, which is better for us. Well, we have here as well, but I think this one is, yep, a bad one, and only this one should be two guys. Okay, so we will just draw the game, it will end in a tie, whatever you want to call it. And That's fine with me. I won't do any more blocks in the last turn because we might fail. I will just score and that will be it. And assuming that the MVP doesn't land on a player that needs less than 5 SPP to level up, we will have 2 level ups to give out. One on our on a blitzer and one on this thrower. So that's pretty good. Let's see. And there's the whistle. And that's totally fine. Oh, so Wasted also got the MVP. So he got a lot of 8 in total. 8? Why 8? Oh, yeah, it's the thrower. I got confused there for a moment. So touchdown plus MVP. 2 injuries and 1 injury. That's really good. Oh, he got both of them in this match. So let's check this out. Let's start with Wasted. We get a normal level up and we have access to general and passing skills. We don't really need passing skills. Leader is something we might want to think about, but I will stay in the general category for now and go with block. Just to make him a little bit safer, and the next skill will most likely be kickoff return. We could switch these, but I think block is the safer choice right now. So let's do this. And he should fairly quickly get the next level up as well, so that we can get him kickoff return. Wasted is a bit harder though, so we have access to general and strength. We have basically 3 big options here right now, I think. For one, tackle, of course, which might be very good against agility teams, and we should get tackle on a player. Then we have guard, which is always a good idea, but we have the black orcs, and this they usually help a lot with our strength advantage. So what? And the last one for now is Mighty Blow, and I think I want to go with Mighty Blow, at least on the first one, just so that we can maybe get an easier player advantage in the future. So that's what we're going to go with. And let's validate that. Okay, so at least we got a draw. That's really nice. And I think this is... I know this is where we will end the episode. I hope you enjoyed this match. If you did, please leave a like and a comment. And if you want to see me play more Blood Bowl, just subscribe if you haven't already. I would really appreciate it. And as always, thanks for watching. I hope that you tune in next time and have a nice day. Bye!